So when we're thinking about how these vaccines are developed, we're thinking particularly about the spike protein. And that spike protein is those little projections that you can see poking off the edge of the virus when you see an image of it in the media. So what the RNA vaccines are doing is simulating that spike protein and displaying it to the body so that it triggers an immune response. So the key thing is, having prepared the body for this, next time the body sees that spike protein, which would be the virus infection itself, it swings into action immediately and starts to attack the virus and protect it from spreading in the body. As soon as they've done their job and that antibody response has been generated, that fragment is excreted from the cell and there's no way at all it can affect the body's normal DNA. When people come forward for a vaccination, they'll be given quite a detailed information sheet, and that will cover some of the really common side effects that people will be familiar with from, say, the flu vaccine. There can be a bit of soreness or discomfort at the injection site. Sometimes there can be a low-grade temperature, so people might feel a bit feverish, and occasionally they may get a headache or some muscle aches and pains. Now, once you've received your vaccination, the staff will ask you to stay around those premises for about 30 minutes. This is really important because if there are any unexpected allergic type reactions, someone will be on hand straight away to deal with that promptly. The development of these RNA vaccines has been the subject of a major international collaboration. The exciting thing is that it's new technology. The amazingly reassuring thing is it's gone through all the normal checks and balances, including extensive international trials, which have helped demonstrate how effective it is.